So now we have got vector multiplication under discussions. We have studied a lot about vectors. We know everything as well about the scalars. And somehow I have told you that I am not satisfied with the definition that is mentioned with regards to the scalar. See, in most places it is given that the scalars are the one which has only the magnitude and not the direction. But already we have studied earlier with a proof that scalar also, like the vector, has both magnitude and the direction. The only difference between the vector and the scalar is that the scalar is that quantity in which the direction is not important, but direction is there. For example, I had told you earlier that consider two different wires in which there are two different amount of current passing. So one is 3 amperes and the other one is 5 amperes. And wherever the two intersect, there the 3 amperes and the 5 amperes current will get added up. So with the result that finally we will have 8 amperes current flowing out. Now, you see these 3 amperes and 5 amperes are in a different direction. The result that is coming out of it is in another different direction. So for all the different directions, we are doing just the arithmetic additions. Because 3 amperes and 5 amperes are in different directions, so nobody can say that 3 plus 5 is, sorry, 3 plus 5 is not equal to 8. We know when two currents get added up, like say 3 and 5, it is equal to 8. So even when directions are different, it is nothing but straight the addition of the values that is there with regards to the current. So here, the directions are not important, but the directions are there. Then in that case, directions are there, but not of significant importance. Then what we have for the current flow is that the result is a scalar. Directions not important. But whereas, we know the force is a vector. Take the same direction. We have got 3 Newton force acting in one direction. And the other direction, we have got 5 Newton force. Now when you add up the two, what you will find is that 3 plus 5 is not equal to 8 like what we have seen for the current. It can be also 4 or it can be 5, 6, anything between, say, 3 or minus 3 up to plus 8. It can be anything. So we can't say how much is the value of that force. So here what happens is because the direction of the two vectors are different, so the sum of the two is not equal to 8, it can be anything between, say, minus 8 to plus 8. So that is the difference. Here direction is important, therefore vector. Here direction is there, not important. So here the result is a scalar. So saying that scalar has no direction is therefore not correct. You take another example that your body is falling down and at a particular point, the velocity is, say, 8 meters per second square. The energy because of that velocity is given by half into m into v square. So if the mass is equal to 2 kg, then this will be equal to half into 2 into v square is 8 square, so that will be equal to 64. And energy is in joules, we have done a lot of problems with regards to that. So this is equal to 64 joules. 64 joules what? It is 64 joules downwards. But sir, this energy or work done or whatever you call it is only a scalar. How can you say downwards? Supposing this body hits after some time a floor and bounces back. Supposing this is a floor which is of perfection, then the rebound velocity will also be equal to 8 meters per second. So now 8 meters per second means we have already seen that the energy that this body is now having will be equal to 64 joules again. Now what do you say? first moving down, then moving upwards, and still you say that scalar does not have a direction. It does have a direction. The direction is reverse, but the magnitude is the same. So scalars also do have directions, but the direction is not important. That is a proper way of giving the definition for a scalar. Now, let us say that a body is falling down and it hits a target like this. Thereafter, it falls. After covering some horizontal distance, it falls on the floor. Now, it's a very smooth surface due to which when the ball impinges on this surface, there isn't no friction or any other loss, so it will be rebounding back with the same velocity. So, same velocity means here also we'll have the same energy but in a different direction. If direction is not important, then if a person is lying down over here, you mean to say that nothing will happen to him? That is all, man. Every chance is there that he's gone. So that is why scalar has got its own direction, but when it comes to the magnitude, the direction is not of significant importance. Right? And supposing a person is sleeping here. Nothing, the body is falling down, nothing will happen to him. Body is falling down, direction has got no effect. If that is the case, then with the same magnitude, this body will hit this person but not hitting because direction has changed. Then how can you say that scalar does not have a direction? You are that wrong, man. So remember that. Scalars have direction, but the direction has no effect in the result. That is the proper way of defining a scalar. Okay. So then, having got a good idea of both the scalar, which is just a repetition of whatever I have told you before, so keeping that in mind, let us look into now that another concept, which is the vector multiplication. You see, vector multiplication is of two different types. One is the multiplication of a vector with a scalar. Another is the multiplication of a vector to another vector, vector to a vector. This multiplication of vector to a vector itself is of two different types. One is called the dot product and the other one is called the cross product. The result of the dot product is a scalar and the result of the cross product is a vector. And what is the difference between the two? We have to see that first. Then we have to also understand why dot product is a scalar and why the other one is a vector. We will look into all of them. Yes, now. Well, a little before, I had been saying that the vector multiplication is of two different types. One is the multiplication of a vector to a scalar. For example, let us take a vector A cap. All of you know the meaning of A and also the bar that is there at the top. I earlier said it is vector A cap. No, it is not cap. It is bar. Sorry. So, this is a vector where the letter represents the magnitude and the cap there. Specify that there is also a definite direction. So, magnitude and direction put up together. It is therefore a vector. And let us say that this vector is having a magnitude given by the length AB. Or CB. Okay, then this is the magnitude and you can also see the direction. That direction is given by A bar. And supposing this vector is multiplied with a scalar like this, 3 a bar. This is just a number. So unmindful of the direction, we have got the number 3. It means that this result is vector multiplied by a scalar, just 3. Therefore, 3 times if you take this vector, then that is going to be the scalar multiplication. And so 3 times that, show it. Three times. So this is A, and after that 2A, and this is 3. So this will be equal to 3A bar. So when a vector is multiplied to a scalar, in the same direction, you have to show the length 3 times. That is the significance of greater 3 here. It's all very simple thing and need not be explained much. We will go to the other type of vector multiplication. This second type of vector multiplication is itself of 2 different types. Now, let us say that we have got a vector having this direction. And the value of this vector is a cap. And we also know that it is equal to not a cap again, well, it is a bar. We have already seen that the vectors is of 2 different types. One is called the scalar multiplication of a vector, and the other one is the vector multiplication with another vector. So in the scalar multiplication, a vector is multiplied to a scalar like what is shown here. The vector is a bar, and the scalar multiplication to the vector is some number because there is no direction. So it is 3a bar. We know the magnitude and direction of A bar. Here also the only vector is A bar again. So this one also will have the same direction. But magnitude is 3 times more than before, that is all. So this is A bar, and this is 1 A bar, this is 2nd A bar, and this is 3 times. So 3 times more than A bar, so this will become 3 A bar. That is all the scalar multiplication of a vector. The other type of multiplication is the vector multiplication. Here, a vector is multiplied to another vector. Okay. So now, we have to therefore take 2 vectors into account. Scalar does not come into the picture here. And one vector that we have shown here is a bar, which is equal to a cap. Magnitude, this represents the direction. So this is the direction for a bar, means this is a cap. And what is the another function of a cap? It is just representing the direction. It does not have any value. Means for multiplication, no value, means this is just equal to 1, that is all. Okay. So then, we will take yet another vector. Let us say this vector is b cap. And we know that like A bar also will be equal to B cap. B cap represents the direction. So this is B cap. Like what we have seen for A cap. Now, what we will do is, we will split this first, or we will split the second vector. We will split it in such a manner that we are taking 2 components, and we all know what exactly does this component move. If you divide a force into 2, then for the single force, these are the 2 components. So this is that component. So like that, we are dividing this vector A into 2 components. One is parallel to the second vector. So parallel to the second one. And what do you know about a component? A big explanation that I had given to all of you before, which is that when you find the component of the vector, it doesn't mean that we are taking the vector itself and finding the division. That is never possible. So Let us say that angle between the two vectors is equal to theta. Component of a vector means don't take the vector straight away, you have to only take the magnitude, take that component. You have to take the magnitude of the component and take that magnitude, find out the value of this in the direction of the other vector, that is in the direction of theta. And we know that in the direction of theta, the component of the magnitude A will be A cos theta. So all of that has been studied very well, A cos theta. And I have seen many, many people that for A in the direction of theta, it will become A cos theta. The unit vector is A cap, so they will write this as A cos theta, A cap. Wrong, man. If the direction is fixed, and this direction is A cap, then in some other direction also, how can you bring the same direction A cap? Means that unit vector or A cap does not have one single direction. The entire, what is it, vector itself goes wrong. The vector chapter itself will go wrong then. So that is why I have said it so many times before, I will repeat it, that it is, some people say component of vector, even that may not be so very correct, but the correct way of saying it is take the magnitude, for that alone take the component, so it becomes A into cos theta. Reason why A into cos theta has been explained before. So A cos theta is a component which we have got in the direction of B vector. So write that component. Please note, in the direction of B vector, unit vector is B. B cap, that is the direction of this B vector. In the same direction we are having A cos theta, means that also will have the same direction, that is B cap. Yes? Yes, man? Okay. So, I repeat all this again. We are taking two vectors. One is A bar and the other one is B bar. Then what you do is, take two components of A bar, one along B bar. And components of a vector means it is not that you take the vector itself directly and find the component in the other direction. We have to take the magnitude of that vector. For the magnitude, take the component. So in the direction theta, it becomes A cos theta, proof discussed earlier. So A cos theta, and now we have got this component in the direction of B vector. So the unit vector of that B vector only can be attributed to A cos theta. This is only right. Component of magnitude of A in the direction of B vector, then the unit vector of B, assign it to A cos theta. So this will be the component of the first vector. Actually, the word component of the vector is not right. Somehow, it has come from traditions. That way, so we will also say it, but don't take the vector to find the component, take the magnitude of the second vector to find the component in the direction of the first vector. Now, what you do is, the first vector is, say, A bar. Second vector is B bar. Take the component of A bar in the direction of B bar. So that will be A cos theta into B cap, then we have got multiplied by, because we are now discussing about dot product, so this multiplication is given the symbol dot. So component of first vector in the direction of the second vector, and assign this direction to the first vector. So this is the component of the first vector, A cos theta B cap, and then multiply this with the second vector. So multiply it, so that will be B bar or B B cap. B bar, A cos theta B cap, that is for the first vector, then B bar for the second vector. This is component in the B direction, and multiply the B vector itself, that is called dot product of A and B. This is called the dot product of A and B. So, what we therefore get is, in the next step, A bar dot B bar is equal to A cos theta. theta b cap component of A vector in the other direction, of course. Then dot is here. Then b cap. B cap is equal to b b cap. I'm sorry, b bar is equal to b b cap. So this will be equivalent to b is just a number, magnitude alone, so bring it together with the other magnitude, so they multiply with each other, becomes a b cos theta. Then here we have got b cap, and dot is there, another b cap. We know this only signifies the direction. Mathematically does not have a value. So in multiplication, it will be just equal to 1, 1 dot 1. So now what happens is that this is just the direction, 1 and 1. So that will be equal to 1 itself. Therefore, what we are having is that A cap dot B cap is equal to AB is equal to AB AB cos theta multiplied by 1 into 1, so it's 1 itself. So this is the result of the dot product. Okay. So now we have got from here, therefore, cos theta. This angle will be equal to A bar dot B bar dividing by this A and B, going to the other side becomes A multiplied by B. So this is how we find the angle between the two vectors by taking the dot product. Okay. Now, there is quite some explanation to prove that why the dot product is a scalar. You see, scalar also has got magnitude and direction, both. But direction is not of any importance. So the reason why it is not important is because I am showing the same diagram again. So the result of component of A in the direction of another vector, A cos theta, in that direction, the direction that is the unit vector is B cap, and another vector is already in that direction, which is B, B cap. So both are in the same direction. So the result also will be in the same direction, say so much. So this is the result. Okay. Now what you do is, this vector, which is the result of the dot product, see it straight. And then see it from the bottom. See it from the top, man. And also see it from the other side. From whatever direction you see it, the result is the same. You will get the same length. See it from the bottom means you should see it at right angles. Don't see it like this. Then you will be looking like a monkey. Okay. So then you have got to see it from right angles. Then what happens is that from whatever direction you see it, you are having the same length throughout. So magnitude is the same from different directions. So here direction is not important. Same magnitude, but direction not important. Means the result is a scalar. This is a nice proof that y dot product is a scalar. Okay. So after having got an idea about the dot product, which is a scalar, and what is the value of dot product, we will also see it more elaborately in a short while.